Good morning, children, and welcome to my factory. Welcome to my chocolate factory. Congratulations to all the winners. Today I will show you the secrets of my factory and begin your amazing journey of how to run a business. I hope you enjoy your time in the new learning adventures you are about to begin, and I believe you will have a marvelous time since you are in my wonderful factory.
I'm Veruca, and I want to go in now.
Hi, I'm Augustus, and I love your chocolate.
I'm Violet, and I will win anything you challenge me with.
Hello, I'm Mike.
Hello, sir. I'm Charlie. Thank you for allowing me into your factory.
Well, come on in, everyone. Now that everyone was in the factory, Willy Wonka will begin to explain the first thing the children will learn about.
The first topic I'll be teaching you about my factory is the history of management and the challenges of what we as managers do on a day-to-day basis. Does anyone know the history of management?
Managing has been around more than 1,000 years. But the modern management dates back to the mid-18th century in England.
That is correct, you two. Management is defined as the process of assembling and using sets of resources in a goal-directed manner to accomplish tasks in an organizational setting. While being a manager might sound easy, there are many challenges that you have to go through every day, like organizing, changes, your resources, planning, directing, and controlling managerial roles. To try to organize a chocolate factory is very hard because each chocolate is simply different and always is changing. I need a plan when each chocolate will be released and when to the world. I had a plan when this contest was going to begin. Also, I had a plan on what the grand prize will be and control what and who is allowed in the factory on a day-to-day basis.
What is the grand prize? I'll win for sure.
Wow.
That sounds difficult, but cool because you have a chocolate factory that you are running. What skills do you have to have?
It is very cool, Charlie. The skills that are needed are pretty easy. I remember it as TIC. The T standing for technical skills, and the I standing for interpersonal skills, and the C standing for conceptual skills.
TIC, like Tic Tac, the candy you can remember it by.
Exactly how I would put it. Technical skills involve having specialized knowledge about procedures, processes, and equipment, and include knowing how and when to use that knowledge. Interpersonal skills are defined as sensitivity, persuasiveness, and empathy that are important for all levels within management. Finally, conceptual skills deal with the logical reasoning, judgment, and analytical abilities
are a relatively strong predictor of effectiveness. Now come on, everyone, onto our next area of the factory.